Hi everyone, this is Manas, your friend and tutor, and guys, another session on deflection of beams. And today it's going to be example number 4, this case. Uniformly distributed load, not on the entire span, but for a particular length of the span, right? How to analyze this, how to frame the moment equation first, and then how to integrate it, get the slope and deflection equations, all of that and much more coming up in today's session. Kaise sari cheezo ko workout karna hai? उसके लिए ध्यान से देखें. और सबसे पहला चीज जो हम लोग करेंगे यहाँ पे, द फर्स्ट थिंग विच विल डू इज टू गेट द वैल्यूज ऑफ रिएक्शंस, एंड दोज रिएक्शंस आर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ आर ए एंड आर बी. अभी इन दोनों को कैसे कैलकुलेट करेंगे, जस्ट वॉच. सो ऑब्वियसली बेबी मैकेनिक्स, एज आई ऑलवेज से, दो फोर्स ऊपर है, एक फोर्स नीचे है. फोर्स कौन सा है? दैट फोर्स इज द यूडीएल इटसेल्फ. सो व्हाट यू कैन एसेंशियली से इज दिस, लेट मी हैव दिस, दैट्स आर ए, that's RB, and 2, and that's 4, 2, 2. Okay, so in this 2 meter span, this UDL can be essentially be replaced by a point load, something like this, isn't it? In 1 meter it is 10, so for 2 meters it is going to be 20 kilonewtons. So what we have essentially done is we have converted this UDL into some sort of a point load, right? 20 kilonewtons acting right at the center between the points C and D. ऐसा आप लिख सकते हो बिंदास. तो पहला इक्वेशन बनेगा आर ए प्लस आर बी. फर्स्ट इक्वेशन इज गोइंग टू बी आर ए प्लस आर बी इज इक्वल टू 20. दैट इज गोइंग टू बी योर इक्वेशन नंबर 1. व्हाट वी आर इंटरेस्टेड इन इज द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ आर ए एंड आर बी. अब वो कैसे करना है, वॉच दिस. सेकेंडली व्हाट वी विल डू इज दैट वी विल टेक द मोमेंट अबाउट एनी पॉइंट, लेट्स से अबाउट एनी कन्वीनियंट पॉइंट, राइट? लेट्स से मोमेंट अबाउट ए इज इक्वल टू 0, आर बी एंटी क्लॉकवाइज, एंड 4 plus 4 is 8 times of RB, anything else, 20 multiplied by this much distance. How much is this? 2 plus this is 1. So 20 multiplied by 3, and that's equal to 0. And you just need to solve this equation. RB will work out as 60 over 8. I don't know what 60 over 8. I need to check. I already have calculated the values. RB will work out as 7.5 kilonewtons, right? RB is going to work out as 7.5 kilo newtons, and you just need to plug this value 7.5 over here. So RA will be equal to 20 minus 7.5. on 20 minus 7.5, I'm very much sure it's equal to 12.5. what? It's in kilonewtons. Just a second, let me see if the camera is rolling or not properly. Yeah, brilliant. So this was the initial calculation to set up the problem. Now let us start with the sectioning. We'll take a section from the origin. Okay, I need to pick the origin also. So I'm going to be picking this leftmost end of the beam as the origin. Right, this is the origin. Here we go. Let's start from here. Section. Lal se likhen kya? Let's start from section. From A at a distance x, and you need to pick the section in such a manner that all the external forces are covered, right? At a distance x from nothing but, well, origin itself, from origin, and we'll try to frame a moment equation. Watch this, very important. Here we go. Okay, let's have a section. Obviously, if you want to cover all the forces, what you need to do is you need to have a section somewhere. Lal se karte hain isko. Here. Right? And what we can do is, that's the portion of beam where we'll be focusing. Done. What else? You've got, obviously, whenever you take the section from the left, we have to moment mx, and then obviously you have this. What is the value, guys? This is 12.5 kN, and obviously you have a UDL. UDL starts here, ends here. Now this is going to be a bit tricky. You've got to follow this religiously. Badi dhyan se dekhiye aap. Okay, we know very well that the magnitude of the UDL has already been given. This is 10 kilonewtons per meter. Brilliant. Now, let us try to take the moment and let me show you what the problem is. Okay. So, this is moment at cross section x, and this distance, you know very well that this distance is x, isn't it? Somewhere here, and that's his x. That means each and every force, beta point load, listen to this very carefully. We are finding the moment at this cross section of the beam, okay, somewhere between D and B. That essentially means that each and every point load, each and every force, beta point load or a uniformly distributed load, is or should be dependent on the value of x. For example, 12.5 multiplied by x will give you the moment over here, okay, right? If you try to frame the moment equation, let's say we are doing this, moment is equal to 0. So the first thing which we'll do is this mx, it is anticlockwise, so take it as positive. Secondly, this 12.5 multiplied by this x, and since it is clockwise, therefore minus 12.5x. Each and everything that you write in the moment equation is or should be depending on the value of x. But if you just take a look at this, take a look at this UDL, it is not depending on x. How much is this? This is how much? Well, that's 2 meters. So if you just want to work out the magnitude of UDL, that will work out as 10 into 2 is 20, and this is going to be that distance, right? In order to make this work, what we'll try to do is we are going to extend this UDL from both the directions, this way, and to be very precise, this, yes, from both the direction. We're extending the UDL from both the directions, right? In that case, the UDL again will be dependent on values of x. Always remember, whenever you take the section, if it does not cut the UDL, then you need to extend the UDL from both the direction, from the top and from the bottom. Once again, if you have a case something like this, and whenever you do the section, the UDL does not cut, then in that case, you need to extend the UDL from top and from bottom in order to maintain the balance of the equation. Remember this, right? So what we'll do is, let's begin. Let us try to frame the moment equation. So this is going to be plus mx minus 12.5x, and apart from that, this UDL. Okay, so let me just mark this distance. So yaar ye ho jayega, this distance, the UDL is acting on this distance, okay, the UDL, the load which is acting in the downward direction, that is this much load which is acting in the downward direction is acting on a span of x minus 2. So that's x, this is 2, so this is going to be x minus 2. And this very small portion, this is going to be, that's x, that's 2 again, so 2 plus 2 is 4, so this distance is going to be x minus 4. The main problem in such cases is only the construction or the framing of moment equation. Once you have framed the moment equation, the entire stuff is history then. It's pretty much the same thing which follows. Okay, so that's over. Now let's work with this. So there is this force, okay, which is acting in the downward direction. How much is this force? This force is 10 multiplied by x minus 2. Obviously, with respect to this particular point, we are taking the moment, right? So it is anticlockwise, so therefore positive sign 10 times of x minus 2. How much is this? X minus 2. Now listen, for 1 meter it is how much? 10 kilonewton. Therefore for x minus 2 meters, it is going to be 10 times of x minus 2, again kilonewtons. So that is about the force. What about the perpendicular distance? Just take a look. This is also fairly interesting. So this is x minus 2. And obviously, this total load, how much is the load? The load is this much. The load is how much? That is 10 into x minus 2. This is acting right at the center of this distance. The center of this distance is obviously going to be this much. This is going to be x minus 2 whole divided by 2. Right? So obviously, this is the force multiplied by perpendicular distance, that is x minus 2 divided by 2, and that's done. Now, what about this UDL? This is acting in the upward direction. So, iska direction agar lagana chahe hum, to yaar isko aise bana lete, I don't know if that is going to be visible or not. Right? So UDL has been converted into a point load, you can say this. Acting in the upper direction, that means a clockwise sense. That means a negative sign. Magnitude again is same, 10 kilonewton per meter, but it is acting in the upper direction. So in 1 meter, it is 10. So for x minus 4 meter, it is going to be 10 times of x minus 4. So that is the force, 10 times of x minus 4. Where is it acting? In the upper direction. And this distance, let me tell you, is half of x minus 4. That is x minus 4 divided by 2, x minus 4 divided by 2. So that is how you need to frame the moment equation. Right? So please note this down and let me try to frame this moment equation in a better fashion. Here we go. Let's write this over here. Kal aise likhte hain yaar. Okay. Ye sara kaam to ho gaya. Mx. You know, what deflection formula says, Mx is equal to Ei d2y by dx square. So d2y by dx square has been written as phi double dash. अब यहां से लिखना चालू करते हैं जे सबको उस तरफ लेके जाएंगे ऑल ऑफ दिस स्टफ इज गोना बी इक्वल टू 0 सबको राइट हैंड साइड में लेके जाएंगे वी विल टेक ऑल ऑफ दीस टर्म्स ओवर टू द राइट हैंड साइड्स देयरफॉर देयर साइंस आर गोइंग टू चेंज स्टार्टिंग विद दिस 12.5x ओके दैट्स इट बिटवीन रीजन एसी दैट इज द ओनली फोर्स 12.5 एंड इट्स मोमेंट इज 12.5x सो लेट्स हैव अ सेपरेशन लाइन AC and what else you've got this plus will become minus 10 by 2 minus 10 by 2 times of x minus 2 and square okay or bhi kuch hai kya or finally ek aur separation line laga do and then we've got plus okay plus corresponds to this force okay 10 by 2 again x minus 4 power 2 plus 10 by 2 x minus 2 to the power 4 and that's it. This is going to be our final moment equation. Let me just very quickly make a check. So here ye aa raha hai 12.5x. Theek hai 10 by 2 x minus 2 ka whole square plus 10 by 2 again x minus 4 ka whole square. X minus 4 hai boss. This is x minus 4. So yaar yahan pe thoda sa truti ho gaya hai. X minus 4. Okay. Done. Brilliant. So what we need to do is we need to integrate this. When you integrate, what will happen? Y double dash will transform to y dash is equal to 12.5x square over 2 plus c1. Again, have the separation line minus 10 times of x minus 2 cube divided by 3 to is 6. Again, plus. Chalo, pehle separation line khich dete hain. Again, a plus sign plus. 10 times of x minus 4 to the power 4 nahi hai mere bhai ye to the power 2 hai 2 hai and this is going to be power 3 divided by kitna ho jayega power 3 3 2 is 6 yeah that's it this is your slope equation anyway so we have a constant c1 and its value can be calculated by applying the boundary conditions sab dekhenge now again we need to integrate this again when you do that this is going to be e I y is equal to 12.5 x cube divided by 6 plus c1 x plus c2 separation line that's ac minus 10 times of x minus 2 power 3 tha na ab power ho jayega 4 and 4 times of 6 is going to be 24 again a separation line and this is going to be plus 10 times of x minus 4 to the power 4 4 times 6 is 24 yet again and that's it. Now, we need to apply the boundary condition. Boundary condition lagana hai. Toh zahir si baat hai, simply supported beam hai. At x is equal to 0, just compress this. At x is equal to 0, you are right here. At end A, that means the deflection is going to be 0. For a simply supported beam, remember this, the deflection at end supports is always 0. That's a boundary condition. So, this can essentially be applied for A as well as B. Okay, so now let's move forward. Let's apply the boundary condition. The first boundary condition is at x is equal to 0, the deflection is 0, just 0, 0, 0, 0. Inside the bracket, negative value, discard 0 minus 4, that is minus 4. Inside the bracket, negative value, discard. Discard these two values. What you are left with is the value of C2 only, which will be equal to 0. In the same manner, we can get the value of C1. Okay, let me just show that to you. How can we get C1? Again, at x is equal to far end. This one. 2 plus 2 plus 4. Kitna ho gaya? 8 ho gaya. At x is equal to 8 meters, y again is going to be 0. So, let us try to frame an equation. Equation to banana padega. So, when we are right here, so all of this, all of these terms have to be considered. Right? All of these terms have to be considered. Ab iska solution kahan pe banaye? Yahan pe karte hain yaar isko, side mein. Just look. Left hand side, 0. The deflection is 0. 12.5. This is going to be x is equal to 12.5 into x cube by 6. 12.5 into x cube. That means 8 cube by 6. Plus 6 C1. Okay. C2 is 0. We know that. Minus 10 times of 8 minus 2 to the power 4 whole divided by 24 plus 10 times of 8 minus 4 to the power 4 divided by 24. So this is what you need to do, right? Use a calculator and get the value of C1. It's one equation, one variable. Let me just check on the equation. Pehla second boundary condition, 12.5 into 8 cube, 6 C1. Not 6. Kuch na kuch mistake kari deta hu main. This is 8. Value of x is 8. Right? Yeah. Looks okay to me. Looks okay. Right? On solving this equation, just try to do this. C1. The value of C1 which you guys are going to get. C1 is equal to minus 79.16. That's it. That's it. Okay. So, we now have the value of C1. We now have the value of C2. We can write these equations again and we can have the finished or refined version of the slope as well as deflection equations. So, chalo, in dono ko pehle likhte hain. What we'll do now, we'll put the value of C2 and C1 into this equation and get the final deflection equation and also the slope equation. Okay, let's do this. Sabko mitaro. Just a second. Okay, here we go. Slope. Obviously, what is the unit going on? That's kilonewton. These two fellows are also in kilonewtons. Everything is kilonewton. RHS is full of kilonewtons. But LHS, if I were to multiply these two fellows, okay, EI will be equal to how much? 12, 2 is 24 multiplied by giga. That means how many zeros? 10 to the power 9. Then 3 more zeros, 10 to the power 12, minus 6, 12 minus 6 is 6. Okay, so you have this, 10 to the power 6. The unit is going to be kilonewton meter square, not kilonewton, but simply newton meter square. The unit over here is going to be newton meter square. So in order to give this some kind of conversion, here, over to the LHS, you need to divide this by 1000. That means 10 to the power 3. Likh lete hain isko, E I Y dash divided by 10 to the power 3 is equal to. Now let us try to frame the entire equation. 12.5 ko 2 se bhaag karo. 12.5 divided by 2 is going to be 6.25. 6.25 x square. Okay. So C1, how much is C1? Minus 79.16. Minus 79.16. Done. Then we've got this. A separation line minus 10 times of minus 10 times of x minus 2 whole cube by 6. Not 10. Instead of writing 10, let me simplify this. 2, 5 is 10. 2, 3 is 6. 5 bate 3 kar lo yaar isko. 5 by 3. X minus 2 whole cube. Okay.
plus 10 times roof. Right? So this is going to be your slope equation. Now let me just write the deflection equation also. Okay, so it's here we go, and this is going to be EIY, again same thing, EIY whole divided by 10 raised to 3 is equal to, yeah, this is this division, let us write it this way, let's not divide it, 12.5 x cube by 6, 12.5 x cube by 6 plus even x minus 79.16 times of x, and then you've got a separation 9, then you have 2 5 is 10, 2 12, minus 5 by 12 x minus 2 power 4, minus 5 by 12 x minus 2 to the power 4, then again a separation line plus again 5 by 12 x minus 4 to the power 4. Sahi likha, 2 5 10, theek hai, 2 12 24, x minus 4 to the power 4. So these are essentially the slope and deflection equations, and now we just need to find out all these values. Once you have these equations, you don't have to worry, you just need to plug the value and get the answer, right? Simple stuff. Okay, so here we go, watch this first part of the problem. Okay, so the calculation is over. Now we have the slope and deflection equations. In the first part of the problem, what we need to work out is the deflection at midspan. Deflection at midspan. Now you know very well that the entire length of the span is 8 meters. So at midspan it's going to be 4 meters. Deflection at x is equal to 4 meters. So you just need to plug the value. अब आपको ये सोचना पड़ेगा कि भाई कौन से टर्म्स को आप कंसिडर करोगे, which terms to consider, which terms to sort of discard. That has to be thought out, right? How are you going to think about that? That is something which I need to tell you. Now watch, guys. Let's start from this equation, EIY. So EI is 24 into 10 raised to 6. 24 into 10 raised to 6. And divided by, you already have 10 to the power 3. We are talking about Y in the midspan, MID, let me just write this simply, is equal to, okay, so we have this deflection equation, 12.5 into x cube over 6. So 12.5 into x cube is nothing but 4 to the power 3 divided by 6 minus 79.16 multiplied by 4. And what else? Just think about this. If you put the value, accept 4 minus 4 is 0, that has to be rejected. Now in this manner we'll try to write it. Let me explain that once again to you. If you put the value of x is equal to 4 in this equation, 4 minus 2 will return a positive value, accepted. 4 minus 4 will return a 0 value. And that is, by the way, you don't have to think about that. Okay, so you need to write it until you reach here. So it's going to be minus 5 by 12 times of 4 minus 2 to the power 4. Looks easy, isn't it? Let me just make a check very quickly. Okay, and these notes will be available. Okay, go check out the description. These notes are available in the PDF format. Yeah, sab sahi hai, sab sahi hai. Right, everything is perfect. 7.915 millimeters. Let me just write the final answer. Y, where in the mid span? Okay, it's a negative value. First of all, let me just put the negative sign. 7.915 into 10 raised to minus 3 meters. So you can also express this as minus, to ab hata do mere bhai. You simply write this as 7.915 millimeters, and this deflection is in the downward direction. That's it. That's it. That's the best way forward. Here we go. So we've now successfully obtained the deflection. What is the second part of the problem? Guys, in the second part of the problem, what we need to do is, we need to find the maximum deflection.
Okay? Maximum deflection. Now, you know very well, the condition is that wherever maximum deflection would happen, in there, slope is going to be equal to zero. You know this very well.
And obviously, if you just take a look at the beam would bend in this fashion. That's the original position, unloaded position. The beam would bend in this fashion. That is point C and that's point D. Obviously, maximum would deflection is somewhere in between C and D. Slope in region CD is equal to zero. So what we'll try to do is, for this CD region only, we'll consider this entire equation and we'll try to see where it becomes zero. Okay, so for this CD region only, what we'll do is, let me just write this equation until here for CD region only. You don't have to go beyond this point D. If you go beyond point D, then in that case, this expression, this term also has to be considered. If you are within or before point D, that means all of these terms have to be taken into account. So let me just write the slope 6.25. What x square minus 79.16 minus 5 by 3 times of x minus 2 whole cube, and all of this stuff is going to be equal to 0. Now some of you guys might be thinking, what the hell is happening? This looks like a cubic equation. Power 3. Yes, it's a cubic equation. So make use of this calculator. 6-700 rupees deke kharide to yaar iska use karo. Right? Make use of the calculator, use the solver, and the value of x, let me tell you, the value of x which you are going to get is going to be equal to, let me just make a check, x ka value aayega kithe gaya nahi maine bola result to ho gaya na hamara 915 wala, x is going to be equal to 3.756 itna aayega, dekho kitna 3.756, ek bar aur dekhte hain, 3.756, isn't it? Yes, that's correct. So on putting this value of x into this equation, when you do that, you will have the maximum deflection. Toh main karke dikhata hun aapko. EI into y, EI kitna hai? EI has been given as 24 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 10 raised to 3, and that's going to be your maximum deflection. Pi max is equal to, and in which region we are in the region CD. That means, obviously, that means if you are in the region CD, that means x is greater than 2 and x is less than 4. Greater than 2 but less than 4, that's it. And that is why you have got this value, which is greater than 2 and less than 4, isn't it? So you have to discard this term, right? This term can only be accepted for all values of x greater than 4. तभी तो यहाँ पे पॉजिटिव वैल्यू आएगा, x माइनस फोर करोगे तो पॉजिटिव आएगा, अदरवाइज नॉट. जस्ट लिसन टू दिस वेरी केयरफुली. इफ x इज मोर देन 4, देन ओनली इनसाइड द ब्रैकेट वी विल गेट अ पॉजिटिव वैल्यू, एंड इन दैट केस वी हैव टू एक्सेप्ट दिस टर्म. बट सिंस द वैल्यू ऑफ x इज ग्रेटर दैन 2 एंड लेस देन 4, वी नो वेरी वेल दैट दिस ऑब्वियसली विल बी अ नेगेटिव वैल्यू, देयरफॉर डिस्कार्ड दिस टर्म. ओके, नाउ 12.5 इंटू 3.756, वॉट power 3, all of this divided by 6, done. Minus 79.16 multiplied by x is how much? 3.756. Sada duster. Oye, 3.756. Okay, or kuch, anything else? Minus 5 by 12 deflection, right? Minus 5 by 12. 3.756 minus 2 to the power 4, and that's it. Just solve this equation, and on solving, what you will get is the maximum value of deflection, or the maximum deflection simply, again, that will be accompanied with a negative sign. Kitna aa raha hai? 7.952 into 10 raised to minus 3 meters, and obviously when you do the conversion, this is going to be 7.952 millimeters. As the deflection is downwards, it is accompanied with a downward sign. Thirdly, व्हाट्स नेक्स्ट? और क्या बोले, ये दो चीजें तो हो गई हैं यार. टिक टिक स्लोप एट ए, दिस इज फेड इजी. स्लोप एट ए, दैट मीन्स यू एसेंशियली नीड टू वर्क आउट दिस थीटा ए. ओके, यू कैन ऑल्सो से दिस इज नथिंग बट वाई डैश ए, सिंपली आई विल राइट इट एज थीटा ए, राइट? सो स्लोप एट ए, कंप्रेस दिस हियर, राइट हियर, बैंग, एक्स. What's x? X is equal to 0. When x is equal to 0, you're right here. That is at end A. And that's exactly where you need to find the slope. Okay, kaise nikalna hai? Toh bhai, ye slope equation hai aapka. EI. EI kitna hai? Ye hai 24 guna 10 ki ghat 6. Bate 10 ki power 3 multiplied by slope at A. Okay? So, x is equal to 0. That becomes a 0. 0 minus 79.16. Even if you put the value x is equal to 0 and 0 over here, inside the bracket minus 2, inside the bracket minus 4. Negative values, discard them. So that's it. You, on solving this equation, you are going to get the value of theta a. Let me just tell you how much theta a will work out. Theta a will be in radians. First of all, let me write this. Theta a in radians will be minus 3.298. Minus 3.298 into 10 raised to minus 3 radians. And secondly, if you try to do a conversion, this is going to be minus. Conversion karne ke liye, what you can do is, you can multiply this, you can multiply it by 180 over pi, and pi is nothing but 3.14 or 22 by 7, whatever. Ye kitna aayega? Minus mein 0.1889. 0.1889 degree. ठीक है, अब ये स्लोप, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू विजुअलाइज दिस एज टू वेयर दिस स्लोप इज एक्टिंग, जस्ट टेक अ लुक ओवर हियर. दिस वॉज द इनिशियल पोजिशन ऑफ द बीम. वेन इट वॉज लोडेड, इट वुड बी समथिंग लाइक दिस, दैट्स पॉइंट ए एंड दैट्स पॉइंट बी. इफ आई वर टू ड्रॉ टैंजेंट एट दिस वेरी पॉइंट ऑन द कर्व, द टैंजेंट वुड बी समथिंग लाइक दिस. द एंगल दैट दिस टैंजेंट मेक्स, गाइस, द एंगल दैट दिस टैंजेंट मेक्स इज इन द क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन. एंड ऑलवेज रिमेंबर, एंगल को क्लॉकवाइज मतलब माइनस में ऐसा एंगल मेजर किया, प्लस इफ यू मेजर द एंगल दिस वे, दिस इज द पॉजिटिव एक्स एक्सिस. इफ यू मेजर द एंगल दिस वे क्लॉकवाइज, दैट इज नेगेटिव. इफ यू मेजर द एंगल दिस वे एंटी क्लॉकवाइज, दैट इज पॉजिटिव. दिस इज द साइन कन्वेंशन व्हिच इज अवेलेबल इन ऑल द टेक्स्ट बुक्स. ओके, एंड दिस इज समथिंग, दिस इज अ वेरी फंडामेंटल कॉन्सेप्ट व्हिच इज अप्लाइड इन ट्रिगोनोमेट्री, राइट? सो दैट्स थीटा ए फॉर यू. एंड सिंस दिस इज measured in the clockwise sense, that's why it is negative. That's it. These are all the answers which we were looking to crack. Okay, so I'm going to be putting up one more tutorial on Macaulay's method, and that is going to be precisely based on a couple. Abhi tak to aapne point loads dekha, uniformly distributed loads dekha, but there is going to be one more case where you'll see that how the deflection can be worked out if at any cross section of the beam we have a couple acting, right? How all those things can be worked out, I'll let you know in the next lecture. So guys, that's all for today. I'll see you again in the next video. Until then, take care, have a nice day, keep learning, keep watching, and thank you.